This is Vic Smeed's book on model boating. Vic Smeed was a British model engineer. He designed model airplanes, a real famous one, a free flight airplane called the Tomboy. Lots of boats, lots of radio control boats. And one of his real well-known designs is the Remora. I'm building over here the Vivacity, which is a big cabin cruiser. I'm going to do a video on that. Anyway, in this book on steam engines, chapter 11, he has this little diagram here of a vertical oscillating steam engine that can power, it says here, up boats from 24 to 30 inches. Build a little boat, little wooden boat, and power it with this engine from Vic Smeed's book. I copied the diagram in the book and blew it up. There's a lot of dimensions that are missing. It doesn't have the stroke and it doesn't have the bore. So I'm just assuming the bore is about 3/8, and there's a lot of little details that are left out. But I think you can make an engine from this based on other engines. I have several other small engine designs. The part of the FizzWiz engine, you could use 3/8 inch bore and a 1/2 inch stroke. So that's what I'm going to use. The main frame is bent out of sheet metal. So I've got a piece of duct worked out of air conditioning duct. There's some scrap left over from a job I did years ago when we remodeled the basement. And I'll make this part of that. And then there's the best look at the engine you have, is this the picture on this side. So I'm going to work on the flywheel. It's right now, it's shows 3/8 by 1.5 inches. I think it's a little big for that engine, but I'm going to go ahead and make it exactly to the Vic Smeed's specifications here and see how it runs, and make any necessary modifications later if I have to get the boat to run. So I'm over at the lathe. This is my South Bend 9-inch lathe. I've got a self-centering 3-jaw chuck in there. I don't have a quick change tool post on this, just a regular old lantern tool post. And I found a piece of scrap steel and in my little cutoff box. It had a 1/4 inch hole in it. I machined a piece of steel slightly oversized and drove it into the hole. And this is measuring 439, and I need to cut it down to 375, 3/8. So I'm going to do that in the lathe right now. I'm going to use the piece of steel that I cut and put in the center as a chucking spud. So I tighten that up. I've got it on the first pulley. Yeah, just eyeballing the how much I'm going to take off until I get close, and I'll measure it. So I'll try to get you a better picture of the cut here. All right, let's measure that out. I got this handy dandy. It was advertised as a digital caliper, and actually it was very cheap, but digital in this case meant it had mechanical digits. It's easy to read, and it actually works pretty good. I think I might have gotten this from Harbor Freight or someplace like that before they merged with MSC. So that's measuring 39393. On this digital caliper. Easy to read though, it works. I'll just compare this with this super cheapo calipers. That's pretty close. Pretty close. This is 393. I'll do the math there. 13 minus 5 is 8. 8 minus 7 is 1. I got 18 thou to take off. What you want to do, I'm going to touch that. Just touch it with the tip of the tool. Don't touch anything else. And I'm going to take my... I have a depth micrometer here. Micrometer stop on the lathe bed. So I'm moving the micrometer stop to zero. Make it easy. Loosen it back up. Now, touch this off. Lock it. Touch the tool against the part gently. Lock the carriage. Actually, that's not the carriage, that's the saddle. Lock the saddle. And then bring the carriage stop, saddle stop, I guess they call it a carriage stop, and push it up against there. Now I have it set on the zero mark. Lock it. Now I can unloosen this. Now I can just turn this in. 18 thousandths. Turn this in 18 thousandths. So let's do that. 10, 15, 16, 17. Now I don't know how my accuracy is on this. So I'm gonna give myself 2 thousandths. So I'm 15, 16. Go to 16. That way I could. You can always take off a little more. You can't. It's really hard to put it back on. So I have this set at 16 thousandths. It's going to let the tool come in 16 thousandths now. All right. Let's see what we got. So I took a couple passes, so I didn't have too much stress on that little quarter-inch chucking spud. And that should be pretty close to 375. Actually, it should be 377. So let's see what I got. All right, it's measuring 375. 370, pretty close to 375 right there. So that's, it's a model engine flywheel. It doesn't have to be, it's not like you're making a jet engine or something. Check it out and see what it looks like. And the drawing on that part is right here. So I've got to drill the center hole and the throw, which will be half of the stroke. The stroke's going to be a half, the throw will be a quarter. So I'm going to lay this out. I'm going to put some dicom on it and lay it out on the surface plate, show you how all that works.